Hello everyone. Today's topic will be Supervisa and its requirement. We are getting lots of inquiries about Supervisa and its requirement. So we are thinking to have a little session on this. Visit visa allow our parents to stay with us up to 6 months and they have to leave Canada. In Supervisa, our parents can stay with us up to 2 years. So what are the requirements? The government of Canada want the host, the person should be a Canadian citizen or permanent resident of Canada, and then they can sponsor their parents on Supervisa. Second requirement is that host should meet minimum income criteria. So what is the minimum income criteria? You will find it on IRCC website. There is a detailed chart. You have to see where are you standing and what are the requirements. So I'm not going to discuss about what is the income criteria. You can see according to your family size and see where are what, how much income is required. We are talking here how to prove that income requirement is made. So first and important document is your notice of assessment. The notice of assessment on line 15,000, you have to see how much your income is for recent tax year. So this is 2021, so you have to see your 2020 tax assessment and see line 15,000, what is the income requirement, and according to IRCC website, check if you are exceeding that income or not. If you are not exceeding your income, you can take your spouse as a co-signer and include her income, and along with your and her income, you should meet the minimum income criteria. This shows that your previous year income has been made. But what about the current year? We have to make sure we also show them that your potential or projected income for this year also meeting. So for that, we need an employment letter from your employer stating that you are working with this company from this date, your current annual salary this much, and that annual salary should meet the current year income requirement too. So that's very, very important document. Notice of assessment, T4 or T1, and then current employment letter, current employment reference letter is very, very important. Once you submit your current employment letter, you have to also support that current employment letter along with your at least three pay stubs and your bank statement showing your salary deposit. So to prove your income, you need notice of assessment, T4 or T1, employment reference letter showing that your annual salary, 3 pay stubs at least, and your bank statement showing your salary deposit. Additionally, if you have a saving that always complement, that always support your financial stability, so saving statement also you can attach from along with the bank letter that you have this much saving. That is your financial stability plus your job stability. Now, once you have that income requirement met, you have to also provide medical insurance. Why government of Canada need medical insurance? Because anyone come on visit visa or super visa, it's not covered under provincial health program. So you have to have your own arrangement, and this is the requirement that you have a medical insurance coverage in case of emergency. So what that medical insurance coverage should, there is a certain criteria for medical insurance coverage. You have to take that medical insurance from Canadian insurance company. The medical insurance should cover at least 100,000 per parent. The coverage should be 100,000 Canadian dollar per parent, and that coverage should be for at least 1 year of period since they arrive in Canada. So this is very, very important, that medical insurance, you have to have that medical insurance. When you submit medical insurance document, you have to provide that medical insurance copy and the proof of payment. You don't have to provide only quote, you have to actually purchase that medical insurance and provide them the evidence that you have purchased this medical insurance. Now, third thing, very important, anyone who comes to Canada for more than 6 months of stay, they have to undergo the medical examination. There is panel physicians. approved by IRCC, and you have to get that medical done from those panel physicians. So in my cases, in my clients' cases, we provide those medical upfront. You don't have to provide upfront medical. You can submit the application, and once immigration IRCC requests you the medical, you can provide them medical examination copy. But if you provide upfront medical, that will save your processing time. So basically, that's requirement. You have to also provide a relationship document. If your mom and dad coming together, so you have to make sure you provide their marriage certificate showing that they are married or they are in common law in that case. Also, you also have to provide that you are a children of theirs. So you have to provide your birth certificate showing that they are your parents. So along with this important requirement, you have to also, sometimes they ask you, most of the time they ask you to provide a police clearance, because background check is important for all of them. You don't have to provide police clearance at the time of submission, but if you have that police clearance from the country they are currently staying, please submit along with your application. It will save your time. In case in future they ask you any police clearance certificate, then you have to process, and that will increase your processing time. So better to provide police clearance along with your application, but that's not mandatory. You can provide it later on too. So this is the basic requirement of super visa. If you follow this requirement, okay, one more thing, the family, how to calculate family size. To calculate family size, we have to consider two factors. One, current family size in household in Canada. So if I'm sponsoring my parents, so I have to calculate my family size. So my family size, me, my wife, and I have two kids, plus I will add the parents I'm sponsoring. So two parents, mom and dad. So it's going to be six family size. So if you wanted to sponsor your mom and dad and in-laws, and then you have to consider your family size and their total family size, then it's total eight. So consider that way, and then you calculate your income according to IRCC website. So family size is very, very important in super visa application, because super visa is only for parents and grandparents. You cannot include dependent, or you cannot include your siblings in this application for super visa. You can, if you wanted to include, you can submit their application along with that, make a separate explanation letter that parents super visa we are applying for, along with we are applying for their minor child or your minor siblings in this application, we are including them. Okay, and that application will be processed according to the visit visa norms. So there are chances it might get rejected, there are chances it might get approval, but again, there is no guarantee that siblings or minor child of parents and grandparents can come to Canada along with them. You can try, but again, there is no guarantee on that. So this is very, very important question. Lots of people ask me, can we include our minor child? So criteria is, super visa is only for parents and grandparents, minor child cannot be included. Now, any kind of super visa or visit visa, the assessment will be done that the person will go back after end of their visa status. So we have to submit a lot of additional document that consists of the parents, if they are working, their employment records, if parents have their property, then property record, property evaluation. If they have the family back home, staying back home, then we need a letter that this family is staying back home, so they have to return back to take care of them in future. So those are the ties to home country. We have to always mention them in the visa application. This way visa application gets stronger, and then officer, when they see all the requirement is met, they approve this super visa for parents and grandparents. Okay, now if the passport is valid for 10 years, the super visa or visit visa, mostly they get validity of the visa stamping is 10 years. So depend on the visit visa, in that 10 years validity, they can come once, they stay six months, they go back, next time they come, they stay 6 months. For super visa, validity of visa is 10 years, but duration of stay can be up to 2 years. Once they come to Canada, without leaving Canada, they can extend for third year, that's possible, or they can leave country and come back anytime they want as far as they are meeting the super visa requirement. I have covered every single thing in this session. If you have any question, please let us know by comments in the comment box, and we will be happy to help you. Hope you like this session. Have a nice day. Bye.